Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Thank you for boarding American Airlines Flight 1640 for our pilot-themed workout. Thanks again for flying with American Airlines. Our three sections include takeoff, flying, and landing. Before we take off, make sure to subscribe and check out my book and other links in the description below. We're getting ready for takeoff, so please fasten your seatbelts and get ready to start with our incline position exercises, including the leg press, barbell press combination, single leg press, incline dumbbell hammer curls, and incline dumbbell skull crushers. Ladies and gentlemen, our weather forecast shows us nothing but blue skies for our 20-hour flight ahead of us. Let's get set up for takeoff with the leg press, barbell press combination. Grab a barbell and set yourself up on a decline leg press machine to work legs and upper chest on an incline. Please place your feet on the middle of the leg press, hip distance, and toes straight. Hold the bar up straight in line with your upper chest with a slight bend in the elbow. Make sure the safety lock is off on the leg press as the weight on both the leg press and the bar descends down simultaneously. Go down as low as you can for the legs, getting the full range of motion without letting your hips and lower back rise off the pad. The arms come down, leaving an inch or two above your chest, keeping the shoulders retracted, a 45 degree arm angle, inhaling down, exhaling up. When pressing back up, the feet press out, keeping the pressure on the heels, and going as far out as you can without locking your knees. The bar is pressed up vertically, going all the way up without locking your elbows, just like the knees. Exhale on the press out and repeat the motion. Single leg presses will give us extra strength for takeoff. Stay in the same position as the double leg press, but only using one leg to push. All the same rules apply as the double leg press, and cut the weight in half. Our single leg or unilateral leg training will help with stability, balance, muscle imbalances, and making sure we pedal the plane in the right direction. Our runway is clear and we're ready to steer the plane using our biceps with incline dumbbell hammer curls. Set up a bench with the back angle at 80 degrees and the seat angle at 30 degrees. Hold two dumbbells and start with the weights hanging by your side. Maintain a proper seated position as you squeeze the biceps with the palms facing each other and curl all the way up and down with full range of motion. The bench position will prevent the elbows from swinging to make sure the form is maintained. Folks, we are officially flying with our final takeoff arm exercise, the incline dumbbell skull crusher. I'm hoping all goes well, as this is my first time flying without assistance. Stay in the same position as the hammer curls, but lift your arms up by your ears. Extend the arms behind your head with full range of motion, just like the biceps, and make sure the elbows stay steady in the same position. Inhale on the way down and exhale on the way up. Hope everyone is enjoying their flight so far. While we're in a flying position, let's get set up for four different medial positions, including wall sit, plate twist,
machine chest flies,
machine reverse flies, and 180 degree shoulder raises. For your own safety, please remain seated until the fasten your seatbelt sign is off. Then feel free to join me in the cockpit for wall sit plate twist. Get set up on a wall to work on the last leg exercise for optimal sitting muscles. Place your back against the wall and slide your back and hips down until you reach a 90 degree angle, and keep a straight posture with the pressure on the heels of your feet. Press a plate out in front of your chest at a horizontal angle with the shoulders retracted and the elbows straight. Once in this position, rotate the shoulders 180 degrees, slowly each direction, working the legs and shoulders simultaneously. Dinner and beverages will be served shortly. Not only is it my first time flying, but it looks like we're flying into some unexpected and unsafe weather territory, so please try and remain calm and seated. I will continue to do my best with machine chest flies. Sit on a chest fly machine and set up the seat height so the handles are at chest level and keep the back straight. The arm handles should be set up at a 90 degree shoulder abduction angle to keep it safe on the shoulders. Start with both arms extended out horizontally with a slight bend in the elbow to work the chest effectively. Fly your arms forward, finishing with hands together, slowly exhaling coming out and inhaling coming back while keeping the shoulders retracted. Squeeze the chest and keep the neck straight. We're experiencing a little bit of turbulence, and even though I sound calm, I'm freaking out on the inside. Continuing our flying exercises with machine reverse flies to work the back of the shoulders. Switch positions with your chest against the pad this time. Maintain your straight posture as you fly the arms behind you. Set up the handles at an angle as close together as possible this time. Fly back to the same 90 degree shoulder abduction angle to keep it safe on the shoulder. Folks will have to reroute this plane, so we will be looking at an extra 10 hours on our flight. I apologize for any inconvenience. Finishing off our flying section with 180 degree shoulder raises. Grab two dumbbells and start with your arms straight by your side and palms facing away from you. Keep the arms straight and raise the weights up above your head at an 180 degree angle.
Ladies and gentlemen, we please ask you to use the restroom if needed as we are getting ready to land with our decline position exercises, including decline sit-ups, back extension dumbbell rows, side crunches on the back extension, and decline push-ups. It looks like we're going to have to make an emergency landing, which will put us another day behind schedule. I apologize for the delay. We will be giving everybody a $12 food voucher when we land to make up for the inconvenience. Get set up on a decline bench for decline sit-ups. Place your ankles on the pad for support and set up the bench at an appropriate angle. As you lean back, have a slight back arch and keep the back and neck in alignment, looking toward the ceiling. Keep your core tight and keep the tension on the abs the whole time. When your back touches the pad, make sure to maintain that tension. Cross your arms over your chest or hands behind the head for neck support. Continuing our decline position exercises with back extension dumbbell rows, rest the back of your ankles on the ankle pad for support and set up the back extension so the top of your hips are resting on the leg pad for support. Hold two dumbbells and let your arms hang as you round your back slowly downward, curving your spine. After going as low down as you can, start to slowly arch back up and straighten your spine again. Finish off with your back in a straight neutral position at the top while performing the dumbbell row and squeezing the glutes at the top. When performing the row, keep your elbows low and raise your elbows up by your side to work the lats and lower back at the same time. Squeeze the upper back at the top of the motion, exhaling up and inhaling down. We just received word that everyone's luggage was placed on the wrong flight. Please fill out a report when you land, and you might receive your luggage in a week or two by the time your vacation is over. Switch to your side to work on the obliques with side crunches on the back extension. Rest your hips on the side, but with the same hip setting to have enough room for your upper body to descend down and back up. Just like the back extension, round and lengthen your obliques on the way down and shorten and contract your obliques on the way up. Work each side one at a time. We have finally landed with decline push-ups. Fortunately, we will have to wait 2 to 3 hours before getting off the plane due to maintenance issues. Place your feet on a bench and your arms and hands on the floor under your chest in line with your shoulders. Keep a neutral back and neck, shoulders back, 45 degree arm angle, abs tight, glutes tight, and go all the way down and back up. Thanks again for watching and boarding with American Airlines. Hope to see you next time.